So right now, we had seen peaceful protesting here throughout the day, but you see this line of police that had made a huge advance down this road here outside the police precinct here, the 5th police precinct here in Minneapolis. That whole intersection right there was filled with hundreds of people until literally 1 minute ago, as these vehicles and line of police officers advanced throwing tear gas. As you see them in there, tear gas filling that entire intersection, and everybody has scattered running towards us. If you look to the right here, you see how many people actually were inside as they are raising their hands there. But look, curfew started less than an hour ago at this point, and this was the night that the governor, officials, and law enforcement say that they were going to stop the rioting and looting and the violence that we had seen play out over nights before. So you see protesters here launching back whatever law enforcement is throwing back in here, but there is so much gas that has been launched again in just the past 2 minutes or so that you can barely even see that line of officers right there. It looks to be state patrol officers right now. But I can't emphasize enough that that intersection was literally filled with hundreds of people until literally a minute and a half ago. And now we are at a standoff where you have a line of police right in front of the 5th Police District here in Minneapolis. And you have the protesters that, again, literally were in that intersection just a few minutes ago, Don. This is a scene that we almost expected to see in some ways because we had not seen any sort of law enforcement presence, again, until it came just within a matter of moments, Don.
Okay, so Omar, listen, we have to stay on these pictures. So Omar, what is that? We see police in tactical gear on the other side of this fence over here, and then protesters on your side of the fence.
That's right.
This is a standoff. Talk to me about what's going on. I mean, this is chaotic, perhaps the most chaotic that we have seen since night before last.
So here we go. We got a little bit of a fire breaking out on the left here as people are being forced back by the police. And you see these police officers and patrol officers are advancing slowly through the intersection as gas is preceding their steps as they are walking vehicles inside as well. At this point, we're trying to stay out of their way. We're going to be over on the side here. Again, you see what is in front of them right now. All of these protesters that are slowly being pushed back further and further, methodically. You have canisters exploding in the ground here, thrown by police officers. You see as they are rolling them into the ground as gas is coming up as well. They are methodically trying to move this group of protesters out of the street, trying to enforce this curfew forcefully, as we are seeing right now, and protesters are continuing to back up. I mean, this is a scene that has developed so quickly, and over the course of the day, we have seen here largely what officials wanted to see. That is peaceful protesting, trying to stick to the message. And, you know, we're going to back up just a little bit here. Our producer got hit. All right. Our producer got hit by some sort of projectile right there. We're going to back up here. You okay? Come on. We gotta move here. Let's back up. Come on. We're going to get back. We're going to move back. We're going to get to a safe spot here, Don. As they continue to methodically work there, we got to move back, fellas. Come on. Let's move. So we got some tear gas in the air here as we're in a brisk jog right now. We are getting away from the patrol officers that are making their way up the street. But I cannot emphasize enough, this is probably the strictest enforcement we have seen of any sort of law enforcement directive throughout this entire week of protests. There have been times where they have allowed the peaceful protest to continue, and then in the evenings, it gets out of control and buildings are set on fire. That does not seem like it's going to be the case here tonight. This is a neighborhood that had been ravaged over the course of last night and even the night before, as the police precinct here, they tried to scale it and do the same thing they did to the 3rd precinct, but they were not quite successful. They did burn out that Wells Fargo, as you see them walking past it right now. But again, you see how methodically these officers are moving through the streets here. Yeah.
Let me jump in here because you're in a strip mall, right? This is a shopping center. And is there anywhere
to go? People are literally taking cover off to the right here.
Yeah, is there anywhere to go here, or is there? You guys aren't blocked in, are you?
We are not. We are off to the right side right here. We got a way to jump out of the right. So we're trying to stay as close as possible to give you a view, but also far enough away so that we don't get a little dose of tear gas like we just did a few moments ago. But as you look literally to the right here, there are people ducking behind bicycles as stuff is tossed back over. This is a scene that people have been retreated back. They're shooting over at us, so we're going to take back. They're probably shooting at the people that were by the bicycles, so we're dipping back to basically where our safe spot is, where we can dip out behind us to the right if need be. But again, we have been here over the course of nights. We have seen the clashes between law enforcement and protesters over the course of nights. This has to be the most methodical and forceful response we have seen from law enforcement in regards to protesters that we have seen over the course of this entire week. Look how far back all of these protesters were pushed in literally a matter of 5 minutes by this unit of law enforcement that came in, advanced together, and it forced them back into a parking lot about a block away, Don.
This is the same strip mall that they showed video of earlier, I believe you and Josh, of residents cleaning up, and now it is just in shambles again. It just shows you the cycle of this. But you're right, Omar, because as you guys have been there, you and Sarah and Josh, police had basically retreated and you didn't see much presence, and now you're seeing a presence. So it appears that police have gotten their acts together. I don't know if they have backup. Does this all appear to be Minneapolis police? Are there National Guard in this? What's the presence here, Omar?
It seems right now, based on their uniforms, we haven't gotten close enough to fully read it, but based on how they are dressed, I believe they are state police officers, based on the ones that I'd seen earlier in the week. And it looks like National Guardsmen as well, based on their uniform, a unit of both of them together. We can imagine supported by Minneapolis police as well. But in regards to specific things that the governor here, Tim Walz, said we would see, they said they would be tripling their law enforcement size to address a, quote, sophisticated network of urban warfare. That came from the head of their state public safety. And then they said this was going to be the largest deployment of National Guard in the state's history. He said they were going to authorize the use of adjoining state resources to include resources from nearby cities and counties. And I think we are seeing the manifestation of some of those orders, where at least in this part of Minneapolis, where it was right outside the 5th precinct here for Minneapolis police, they do not seem to be playing games. They seem to be trying to make a statement. Again, we are 50 minutes into the curfew here in Minneapolis. Hundreds have not adhered to the curfew. As we see, that camera person just got shot. They just shot at that man. He clearly has press on his helmet right there. We have seen that multiple times over the course of protests nationwide. But even as they've been pushed back, there are people that are still advancing now towards that line of officers. Oh, another shot right there. Back up. Let's back up behind this corner. We are going around the corner because they do not seem to be distinguishing.
They're not discriminating at who they're shooting. Right. So they're not discriminating here. So who's shooting and what are they shooting, Omar?
It appears they seem to be, let's look around the corner here, Lionel. They are moving around and securing this area on the left side. They seem to be shooting, Bill, I'm talking to my producer here. Bill, how would you describe what you got hit with?
I don't know if it was a rubber bullet. Something hit me on my back right shoulder and knocked me down. It may have been a rubber bullet. I couldn't even see it coming at me. It just hit me so hard and fast.
That's right. Okay, so that's my producer, Bill Kirkos, as we were walking away from that area. Oh, and a guy standing next to us just got hit by one of those pellets. We were standing behind cover for that very exact reason. But they do seem to be pellets of some sort that give off a green gas once they make contact. And I'm looking off my photographer's camera, who's literally peering it around the corner so that we don't risk getting shot ourselves with some of these pellets. But again, This is the enforcement they promised and wanted to have over the course of the past few nights. And one of the things Minneapolis Mayor Jacob Frey talked about was trying to even the ratio between law enforcement and protesters, which he says they have been severely outmatched over the course of the past few days. The ratio does still seem to be off in regards to hundreds versus what we're looking at right now, but the power and the methods they seem to be using without question and without hesitation is the main difference than what we have seen over the course of the past few days, Don.